World of Hip Hop. We here with the man that started this shit for all of us. For all the rappers, for all the breakdancers, for all the DJs. This is the godfather of hip hop right here. The originator.
Father.
The father of hip hop, excuse me.
Godfather,
the father. The big daddy of hip hop, Cool Herc.
Peace, man.
First thing I want to thank you for is for stopping some cats from whooping my ass when I was about 11 years old over up in the Bronx, about 2 miles from here, where my cousins brought me out here to watch you in the park.
You should have came over curfew time.
I was out here, I was with my peoples, I was seeing rap music from the essence.
Funny how times fly, we having fun, man. That's what the whole game was about. You're young, coming up, and having fun, man.
So, first of all, I want to let everybody know, Cool Herc stopped some niggas from robbing me and stabbing me when I was 11 years old. But on to bigger and better things. I was watching something on C-SPAN the other day, and these white men in Washington is about to use rap music amongst other cultural things to try and know better things over and like overseas and the Arabs and all of that. And it's a shame that a man like you that started this. How do you feel about that? Something you created, but a lot of things you don't get credit for.
That's true too. But overseas, there's a lot of love over there, man. There's a lot of love, more love than I ever could experience, man, far as something I started, and people show me the appreciation of it, man. I get more love and respect overseas than here.
That's right. Another thing I noticed is that I see you on a lot of documentaries and DVDs that's on the street and in some of these little mom and pop record stores, but
I'm not getting paid for a couple of them. Right now, there's a few of them that's in litigation. You know, I don't mind somebody give me an interview, but let me know what you're going to do with it. You know what I'm saying? I'm not here to hold by nobody for making some money, but at the same time, too, I got to eat, too. You know what I'm saying? And that's what I'm very critical about, giving interviews to people, because, hey, if you're going to help you make some money, let me know, because I'm a part of it. I'm not trying to stick you up. You know, but that's how it goes, man. The discontinue, man, constantly.
All right, I hear that.
You know what? If anybody out there want to collect my money from me, let me know. You get a percentage. All right, trust me. If you want to, I can't do it. If I do it, what use does it make me being behind bars? So if you got the guts to go collect Cool Herc money that Cool Herc was to get, hey, my brother, get me mine and take yours out of it.
We got your trade numbers after this, because I got a few DVDs to show you.
The squad just stepped in. You know Cool Herc? What Cool ever done for you? Oh, I got a big call from hip hop. Oh, I got a, yeah? Well, what have you done for him lately?
Some of these niggas ain't done this shit for you ever.
Then you collect.
Some of these niggas ain't even done shit for you ever.
Don't hurt nobody. Don't kill nobody. Don't bruise nobody. Let's collect.
Nah,
make sure that they have a problem sleeping at night.
Yo, this is Cool Herc. This is the man. All right.
Please collect my loose money. Please collect it.
All right, hip-hop, you started this thing back in what, 1970?
Yeah, 71, 72.
What would you consider the 5 biggest things that's happened in our culture since you started this thing back in 71?
Me? I gave the kids another avenue to make money. Besides being a drug dealer, this is something that you could make money off of. The cop, nobody could drop a dime on you with it. Also, give you a chance, a kid, to make some money before the age of 21. You see that guy, a little Bow Wow, little Romeo. There was another avenue I gave kids to pursue to make some money and make a living out of it. Also,
one thing you did, you made it a lot easier for us black men to bang white chicks nowadays.
That's true. You know, once you hit them, it's always a magic question. I never felt like this before. You know, but all fun and jokes aside, also, I gave the American culture, the American USA, it was the second form of creation besides jazz, blues, and rock and roll, hip hop. It was one of the fourth music form that was created here. And I'm living to see it. And ancestors that crossed over, like Miles Davis, dug it and did something with my man Easy Mo B. That's to my heart. I'm not on a record, but I know where that came from. And I take credit for that. That Miles Davis, God rest his soul, got down with Easy Mo B and did something. Also Guru did something with Donald Byrd, hip hop style. So Hey, man. And to see brothers like LL Cool J from Wax to sitcom to movie, that's a big plus. To hear Bongo Rock being performed at by the New York Breakers for Ronald Reagan inauguration, that's a big plus. But along the way, the biggest thing right now, my disappointment with it, is the abuse of the culture. Unscrupulous characters in the business abusing it. They're not giving nothing back. They don't have nothing constructive from a youth point of view that hip-hop have helped a lot of people eating. And they're not giving back, man. You know, I hate to see these kids, these kids walking around with their pants off their ass. It's cool, but where they get it from? They get it from these artists that doing that same bullshit, negative prison type shit that they need. If a kid can watch, emulate you with your pants to your ankle, can you do something else for them to emulate and do? Can you do something else? Because you owe a mom that bringing up that kid by herself while daddy locked up. You owe that shit to do something to help that kid grow. You're part of the village. If you're not a part of the village, you need to get the fuck out of it. Alright? That's what I'm talking to you. These kids need to dress a little more appropriate coming up. Pants under their ass, that's no fucking fashion shit at all. And y'all grown ass motherfuckers out there that's living well off this shit, acting like you're a fucking kid. Come on, man, get up out of it, man. You're on the platform, make use of it. You're on the platform, demand attention, make use of that shit. All your moguls too, talk about hip-hop shit and all that shit. You're still letting motherfuckers get in the way with shit that you are producing. And you know the fuck y'all are. Okay, y'all don't owe me nothing. I'm still living. I can walk the street without bodyguards. You can't do that. I got more money than you ever will for respect. You can't buy that.
That's right. Cool Herc. I got one more question to ask you. It's a little off the track. Where you get your socks and drawers from? Because if I put on my Cool Herc socks and drawers, maybe I have one tenth of the influence and things you've done to this city and this whole world, and, you know, the planet Earth.
My girl bought me that, man.
Yo, this is Cool Herc.
Nice woman that's behind me, you know. I'm a father of children out there, but there's somebody that came along my life that, you know, gave me another viewpoint to look at things, you know.
You hear that, y'all? All right, World of Hip Hop, we're about to kick into some old school shit. This is my man Cool Herc, World of Hip Hop. If you can't do a one-tenth as good as him, you need to get the fuck out of here.
I'm gonna tell you something too. Hip Hop is live and well. You don't hear no problem overseas with hip hop. Only problem is here. The business of hip hop is in a fucked up state. So all the people that got up in there and they get their business shit correct, Zan Afkoff is coming after you.
World of Hip Hop.
Homeland Security.